Well, tomorrow is the big test. Can Hillary Clinton turn the tide on Bernie Sanders' momentum, who's won 8 out of 9, and can she get it done here in the Empire State? The Sanders campaign refuses to acknowledge the polls, pointing to record crowds and fabulous turnouts across the state of New York. Sanders has beaten poll numbers in the past, but can he turn these big crowds into votes? We now turn to Caleb Maupin, who is at another Sanders rally here in New York City. Caleb, these crowds have given the Sanders campaign a tremendous amount of confidence. Do you feel that tonight?
Oh, absolutely. We're here in Long Island City, in New York City's borough of Queens. We're just across the river from the United Nations headquarters in the Empire State Building. And right now, behind me, Bernie Sanders is on stage. He was introduced by the actor Danny Glover, and he is speaking to a crowd of thousands of people with his usual message about the influence of corporate lobbyists and money in politics. There are thousands of New Yorkers from all across the city, all across the state, here to see Bernie Sanders on the eve of the New York primary. We spoke to some of them earlier about Bernie Sanders and the hopes for his campaign, and here's what they told us.
Bernie Sanders will be in the fight with you. I looked at his record. I look at old YouTube videos, and I just saw the fight that he has stood for the common man. My union, TWU, we recognize that fight.
He's out for everybody, the homeless, the veterans. He wants his for the people that earn a living wage. I'm out here trying to make the people earn a living wage at this point, help support them. He's talking from his heart. He's not like Donald Trump is segregating people.
Only Bernie is going after them, and he has nothing that supports him except his voters. He is beholden to nobody. All the other candidates, either party, are beholden to financial support from Wall Street, the insurance industry, real estate, and on.
So, we spoke to a number of his supporters at the rally, and a lot of them are telling us they don't quite believe some of the poll numbers that they're hearing. And they say that there's a lot of support for Sanders on the streets of New York City and that they remain optimistic. And a lot of them say that no matter what happens tomorrow, they will be supporting Bernie Sanders right up until the convention. So a huge outpouring here in Queens, huge outpourings throughout the weekend here in New York City. As we go into tomorrow's primary, it remains very, very close.
And Caleb, do you get a sense talking to these supporters that they actually believe that Bernie can win in New York? And do they really feel the burn, so to speak, to the point where they think, hey, he's going to win this thing? What about that?
Well, it seemed like a lot of the people we spoke to were actually first-time voters. These weren't, you know, typical Democrats who just favored Bernie Sanders. And a lot of them said that they had never voted before in their lives. And they said that they felt that, like, Bernie Sanders had an appeal among people who aren't typical, regularly involved in the process. So it was an interesting conversation we had with a lot of the supporters, thousands of them here in Queens, across the river from the United Nations and the Empire State Building.
All right, Caleb Maupin reporting tonight from Queens here in New York City. And of course, the polls have been telling a real story about Hillary Clinton. She is still very strong in this state. In fact, the only poll that we have found in previous days, about a week ago, was the Gravis poll. It's the best number so far for Bernie Sanders, where he drew within 53% to 47%. But throughout this process, he has been the chaser in the numbers game, no question about it.